for the gates of pearl.
My record bride,
watching both day and night, I'm getting ready to leave this world.
I'm getting ready to leave this world. I'm getting ready
for the gates of pearl.
My record bride,
watching both day and night, I'm getting ready to leave this world.
Good morning. Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
There we go. Bear with me this morning. We got quite a few announcements here. There will be a revival at Pine Grove Holy Church of Christ on Highway 69 and Banks Road in the Boldo community. The Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday night, May the 14th, 15th, and the 16th at 7 p.m. Brother Jamie Suggs. Did I say that correct? Okay. Will be the evangelist, so please, he's a minister from Moulton, so please come out and help support that revival. Also, next Sunday will be Youth Sunday, and then on May 21st, they'll have the Young at Heart lunch. They'll have ham. Please see Miss Lavonda if you'd like to bring a dish. Also, the 27th of this month will be our homecoming. Special singers will be New Ground. We will have lunch at noon, and I did that for a reason.
It's May the 5th. May the 12th.
Yeah, 12th. Also, Kingdom's Kids, May 9th, they'll have a dinner for donations here at 545, salad and baked spaghetti, no charge, donations accepted. Also, the youth will be going to the ramp June 7th through the 9th. If you'd like to have a calendar of youth events, please see Amanda. Do we have any more announcements? May 19th will be the benefit singing at 6 on Saturday, but 6 p.m. So please come out and support that. Do we have any more?
Next Saturday, Jamie needs some more help under this stage.
Yeah, that's where I hung out yesterday, was underneath the stage.
Jamie, next Saturday will be casual dressed.
Casual dressed. Do we have any more announcements? If you ever get the opportunity to go up underneath the stage, do it, I dare you. At this time, does anybody have any birthdays? Do we have any birthdays or anniversaries? Yeah, Charlie.
Just let him stand up back there.
Yeah, just let him stand
right
there.
Stand up right there.
Was everybody, when I turned the microphone off, could everybody hear that announcement? Okay.
Yeah.
Making sure.
Other miracle, y'all.
Happy birthday to you.
this time, I'll ask everyone if they would please stand. We'll take up this morning offering. If I could have three men to come forward. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, I come to you this morning, Lord, and what a privilege it is to be able to come to you. God, I just thank you for everyone that's come out here this morning, Lord. Be with our youth this morning as they put on the drama, Lord. I just pray that the Holy Spirit just pours out onto this service, Father. Lord, be with Brother Sam this morning as he brings our message to us. And now we ask you just bless this offering, Lord, that it may go to further thy kingdom. And we ask all this in your name. Amen.
Page 180.
Morning. We want to go to the Lord in prayer. We know that there's a lot to pray about. And we know God has all power. And we know that He loves His believing children, don't we? So if we know these things, why don't we act upon them? So God wants us to. He wants us to pray one for another. Let's do that. Let's remember those who are fighting cancer. Let's be with Carol and Wayne and Roger. And we know that He can help us and me and anybody who has a battle to face with God. God can help us. He can help us face our battles and give us strength and understanding so we can get through them. Also had a special prayer request for Lanelle Puckett. She's had some problems with her legs this morning, and she can't be with us. But at this time, if you have a spoken request, amen. Anyone else? Let's remember that. Anyone else? Linda? Let's remember them. Anyone else? Tim? Let's remember that. Yeah, Brother Jamie Suggs is going to hold the revival out at Pine Grove. He's also the pastor at Pleasant Ridge up in Moulton Valley. He has a daughter that's spinal bifida, and her shunt has quit working, and she's in Children's Hospital. And they desire our prayer. And we know that God has all power, and He can touch. Let's pray for them. Let's remember them. Jamie I thoroughly enjoy hearing him preach. He is truly, I think, a man of God. And let's remember and hold him up. He's a younger than me. He's not young, but he's younger than I am. But he's probably close to 40. But let's remember him and his family that God will bless. Anyone else? Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Those who want to, let's come on up.
Lead us, guide us, that we may one day make heaven our home. Thank you, Lord, for your love and your goodness. Amen.
Testing. How great is our God?
The cordless is right up. Grace that taught my heart to Okay, go. Make sure the ringer's off.
Oh.
Sorry. If y'all don't care, I want y'all to come down here, and I want everybody to circle around these kids, and all the kids that are out here, just come up and let's circle around these kids and pray. You know, Stacy, a while ago when the music had a little thing there, and she ran off and she said, we will not be defeated. And sometimes we feel defeated, amen? Little things, big things, they get in the way. And these kids face things every day too, things that we don't know about, things that they don't want to tell us about. And, you know, it does me so good to come into this church and to work with them and to be with them. And we just need to lift them up and pray for them that they'll not be defeated and that they'll not feel defeated in the things that they face every day. And y'all just pray for me that I'll keep guiding them in the right direction along with all these others and along with all your help. But if we will, Brother Sam, if you'll just lead us in prayer over these kids.
Yeah. You ever feel insufficient? Yeah. We were talking in Sunday school about giving back. And those who had talents to give. God wants us to give back. We have different talents, each and every one of us. But I'm glad that the children are really working to give us back what God gives them. Amen. I thank Him for that. And I feel insufficient even following Him. But you know, as a child of God, I have a responsibility to God too. And He wants us to serve Him. Just like these children were serving up here. He wants us to be that humble and that willing to serve Him. Amen? And we have to become willing and humble to even be saved. Amen? Have you been willing and humble to serve God in your life this week? Better be. You better be where He wants you to be. You know, in the last couple of weeks we were talking on an awakening. It's time that we wake up. Christ is coming back. And He's coming back for a prepared people. For people who love Him. Amen. Who are willing to give of themselves back to the world. Amen. Are you willing to give back? Better be. Better be ready. We are blessed. Whew. To have God with us, amen. That's a joy within itself. You know, you can't go just anywhere and find God's Spirit and His love dwelling in His people like I feel right now this morning, and what the children brought when they were singing and doing the things that they wanted to for God. Amen. Did you not feel the power of God in those things and in their meeting and in their dance and in their moves like God was with them? Amen. You can tell I did. God loves us when we're obedient to Him. Amen. He wants us to be willing and humble and obedient. Whew. And I'm glad they were. I don't know about you, but I've got a blessing just by being here. Amen. Just by being here in God's house, God blesses us. Amen. In the last 2 weeks, the Lord's been dealing with me on things to wake up the church and our people. Things about God. Amen. Have you been thinking on God, or do you just come out of a routine? Now, we as people have routines, don't we, Johnny? Huh? I have things that I do repeatedly, and so do you. Most of you know where you're going to come sit every day in the church, right? Come on. Everybody's got a spot, right? What happens when you have to move out of your spot? Huh? Well, God wants you to move out of His spot every now and then. He wants you to listen and obey Him and move when He says move. And it might be different from where you've been and where you've been going, and it might not be in your spot. Amen. Now, God wants you to move when He wants you to move, not when you want to. Yeah. Not when you want to. We're stubborn. I'm telling you, I'm about as stubborn as most people. Amen. I'm stubborn too, just like it. But when God wants us to move, we need to move. Amen. God wants you to move this day, you better do it. Whoo! But when you do, there's blessings. Amen. Woo-hoo. Woo. Oh, thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Those children not give you a blessing. There's false prophets on every hand today. Come on. They're teaching feel good. And it's okay to do that. God's love. And that'll be okay, relationship with God. Well, it ain't. Let me tell you. Amen. God has rules and regulations. Amen. You have to come willing and humble, and you have to submit to God's rules and His regulations. Amen. But when you do, woo, there's blessings, amen. Isn't there? There's blessings when you follow God's rules and regulations, amen. He did it for a purpose. The purpose is to save you from your sin and let you walk a straight and narrow path toward Him so you can make it to heaven where He is, amen. Do you observe His rules? Are you listening? Are you doing what you need to do? What about these false prophets? They'll teach you can do anything and serve God. But God don't go along with that. Amen. He doesn't. God wants people who are willing and humble and ready to give back to God. Amen. Found that out today in the Sunday school lesson, didn't we? God gives. Let me tell you something else, people. When we start giving back to God, He gives back again. Amen. He'll give you portions that you can't receive, and it pours out on other people and makes a difference in their life too. So obey God. Listen to Him so it can bubble over and change other people other than yourself. Amen. That's what we need to do. We need to be willing and ready to listen to what God wants us to do. Are you ready? Are you willing to do what God wants to do? Have you drifted from far from our Lord? And are we so blinded by our sins that we can't see the truth? What is the truth? Christ Jesus. He's the truth and the light. Come on. God sent His Son, Christ Jesus, to be the light of this world. That's right. and for us to die for our sins so this light of this world might be applied in our life to get the darkness out of us, which is the devil, amen. From the darkness to the light through Christ Jesus. Amen. Are we so separated from God that we can't see our faults? Are we so far, we drifted so far away from God that we can't feel Him in our life? You can't tell me you didn't feel something when the children was doing their thing. You can't tell me that God wasn't dealing with His people. Amen. God's alive and He deals with the people who love Him. Amen. And He just confirmed that. Amen. He loves us. And He's confirmed that in our meetings. Amen. We need to confirm it with our actions. Amen. And serve God and do what He wants. Have you been so far from the Spirit of God that the feeling's gone? Huh? You ever wonder how you get it back? Let me tell you how to get it back. Huh? Get on your knees. You get back, get on your knees. Talk to God. Amen. He'll put you in a place where you can get it back. Amen. He'll share it back with you. Amen. Don't you want Him in your life? We need change in this world. We need an awakening from God. Amen. God will wake us up if we'll listen and look and do the things that He wants. It's time that we wake up and get away from the sinful world and get back to where God wants us in our lives and know that sin will separate you from God. Come on. All these people that's preaching of do good and God's love, but if you got sin in your life, it's going to separate you from God. Amen. You can't have it. You need God alive and well in your heart. Our God will let you know when you're drifting away from Him. Come on. He'll let you know. He has ways to wake you up. I bet you have one of you. And I'm going to say this is for Sam. I've had dreams at night of terrible things going to happen to me because I was away from God. And have to wake up and pray right there on my knees on the side of the bed before. Amen. Lord, don't do that. Lord, forgive me of what I've done. Lord, here I am. I'm humble. I'll listen to you. Amen. Come back in my heart. He'll send you ways to let you know that you're drifting. When you're getting away from God, God will give you things in your life to wake you up. Awaken you from out of your sin and your distress of sin, where it separates you from God. Amen. That's why, throughout the Bible, God has ways of awakening people. All through the Bible. I'm going to read you a couple of them here in a minute. And He has ways today, doesn't He, Brother Johnny? To get our attention, to wake us up so that we can serve Him. This morning was an awakening. Amen. They woke up the Spirit of God up here. Amen. And it's good. And it's bubbling over. And it affected other people. I don't know how many of you, but it affected Sam Cain. Amen. God's Word affect people. Amen. We're going to talk to you about Christ. And we're going to talk to you about another king who found out he wasn't serving God like he was supposed to, and it scared him, amen. It should scare you not have God in your life, amen. He loves you and He wants you to serve Him. Brother Robert, you got my song? I'm ready. This is an old one. It's called Come to the Well. And the reason why I'm playing it, I'm going to talk to you about the woman at the well here in a minute. And how God changed her life.
Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. Leave it all behind. I have what you need, but you keep on searching. I've done all the work, but you keep on working. When you're running on empty,
you ever been there?
You can't find the remedy.
You thought you was at your just end, running on it. God can fill you back up. Woo.
You can spend your whole life chasing what's missing, but that empty inside, you just ain't gonna listen when nothing can satisfy.
You ever been there?
And the world leaves you high and dry. Just come to the well.
It is Christ, amen. It is God's Spirit. That's what you need, amen. You can live without anything else, but you don't need to live without God in your life, amen.
So bring me your heart, no matter how broken. Just come as you are, when your last prayer is spoken. Just rest in my arms. When you come to the well, it's all who thirst will thirst no more, and all who search will find what their souls long for. The world will try, but it can never fail, so leave it all behind. Come to the well. Joy's gonna flow like a stream in the desert. Soon all the world will see the living water is found in me. 'Cause you come to the well.
Are you ready to leave the things of this world behind and let God lead you in a direction that will change your life forever? A lot of people don't like change. I mean, I don't. If it changes, you know, I've talked about we having places to sit. We're creatures of habit. We don't like change that much, especially when it affects us. It's okay if it affects somebody else. But if it affects me, we don't like it too much, do we? We need to get to where God wants us to be. and he'll change your life. But he'll change your life with joy, peace, happiness, and things not of this world. Amen. Don't you want some things not of this world, but of God, like His Spirit? How wonderful it is to fill Him. Now, if you'll turn over in the old Bible in Kings, 2 Kings, the 22nd chapter. We're going to read to you some there. We're going to start down with about the 8th verse. And this particular king, if you'll look up the top of this chapter, and I can't on mine because it's cut off, and his name is Hezekiah. Anybody there on? Yeah, Hezekiah. He was king. And they had been disrepair in the temple of God. They had let it fall into some sort of ruin. And he was trying to find out to get the money for the workers of the people there, the carpenters, the stonemasons, and the people who were working on the church, Brother Gary. And so he, in their work, the chief priest of the temple found a book. Amen? If you look down to verse 8, that's where we're going to start. And Hilkiah, the high priest, said unto Shaphan the scribe, I have found the book of the law in the house of the Lord. And Hilkiah gave the book to Shaphan. He read it. And Shaphan the scribe came to the king and brought the king word again and said, thy servants have gathered the money that was found in the house and have delivered it into the hands of them that do the work and have the oversight of the house of the Lord. And Shaphan the scribe shewed the king, said, Hilkiah the priest has delivered me a book. And Shaphan read it before the king. And it came to pass, when the king heard the words of the book of the law, he rent his clothes. Now when he heard the word of God and what they were supposed to be doing for him, he knew they weren't. He knew they weren't doing what God had told them to do. And it scared him. So in their days, they would rent, tear their clothing, and get in sackcloth and ashes and pray. In this particular case, he just rent. He tore his clothing because he was scared and ashamed of what they hadn't been doing for God. Amen. Now you talk about an awakening. He had an enlightening moment, didn't he? What did you have in your life when God come in your heart and your life? Did He awaken you? Did He enlighten you that you needed Him in your life? If He hadn't, He will if you'll let Him. But see, this works. You have to want Him in. Amen. He's not going to force Himself in. You have to let Him in. Okay, when this king heard what they were supposed to be doing for God and they weren't, it scared him. It made him want to do what was right in God's eyes. Amen. When Christ come into your heart and your life, it makes you want to do what He wants you to do in your life. Amen. Not what the world wants or what you want or what the devil has blinded you with, but what God wants in your life. Are you listening? Or are you like the king? They had lost the book that you're supposed to hear. Have you lost your way? Have you not heard the word of God? That's your problem, isn't it? You're supposed to know it. There's no excuses anymore. You have the Bible to lead and guide you. You have access to the Bible if you live in the United States. Amen. There's no excuses. You need to know this God. And the king commanded Hilkiah the priest and Akim the son of Shaphan and Achbor the son of Michan and Shaphan the scribe and Ahazah the servant of the king, saying, now he put these men in charge. He says, go ye and inquire. Go find out something for me about this book. I need to know. I need to know what God wants us to do, amen. You need to know in your life what God wants you to do too, amen. And let me tell you, let me give you a little hint. It's to serve Him. You need to serve God. Now, we all have different things to do for God. We all have different talents. But He wants us to use them for Him. Go inquire of the Lord for me, amen. And for the people and for all of Judah concerning the words of this book that is found. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is kindled against us, because our fathers have not hearkened unto the words of this book and do according to all which is written concerning us. Amen. They have been doing what they were supposed to do by the book of God, His laws. Amen. They had went their headlong ways and offered up incense and had false gods in the land. Amen. Where are we today? What God is in your life? Come on. We have gods in our life. Which God are we serving? Are we like King here? Has this new book scared him? The book of the Lord scared you because you're not following it? Amen. If you're not following, you ought to be scared. Amen. If you're not following after God, you're in troublesome ways. Amen. It's time to be worried. Amen. Because you need God in your life. So Hilkiah the priest, and Akam, and Achbor, and Shaphan, and Esaiah went into Huda, the prophetess, the wife of Shallum, the son of Tikva, the son of Harkas, keeper of the wardrobe. Now she dwelt in Jerusalem, in the college, and they communed with her. They didn't know how to get in touch with God. That's terrible, isn't it? A priest of God not knowing how to get in touch with God. They had to go search out someone who knew God. That's terrible. But we've been there, haven't we? Did we not have to search out somebody that knew God? Did we not go to church to hear that somebody could preach to us the Word of God, that it might condemn us, that we might come forth and be saved? Amen. So they were searching out somebody that knew about God. She's going to awaken them, isn't she? She's going to wake them up a little bit. And she said unto them, now if you skip down on over to the 15th verse of the 22nd chapter, and it reads like this. And she said unto them, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, tell the man that sent you to me. She didn't even call him the king. She's going, tell the man that sent you to me, God says this. Uh-huh. Now sometimes we don't like what God's going to tell us, do we? But in this case, it was a good report. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will bring evil upon this place and upon the inhabitants thereof, even all the words of this book which the king of Judah hath read. Everything that he said he was going to do, he's going to do. Amen. Because they have forsaken me and have burned incense to other gods, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hand. Therefore my wrath shall be kindled against this place and shall not be quenched. So his wrath is angered, and it's not going to be quenched. He's going to follow through. Amen. God's going to keep his promises. But the king of Judah, which sent you to inquire, but the king of Judah, which sent you to inquire of the Lord, thus shall ye say to him. Now listen to me. Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, and touching the words which thou hast heard, because thine heart was tender, and thou hast humbled thyself before the Lord when thou heardest what I spake against this place and against the inhabitants thereof, that they should become desolation and a curse, and has rent thy clothing and wept before me, I have also heard thee, saith the Lord. Behold, therefore, I will gather thee unto thy fathers, and thou shalt be gathered into thy grave in peace, and thine eyes shall not see all the evil which I bring upon this place. And they brought the king word again. Amen and amen. God knew this man. He was changed when he heard the word. Amen. He says, I'm still going to bring the evil, but I'm not going to bring it on you. Amen. Get the word. God can use it so he don't have to bring evil against you. Amen. You need God in your life today more than ever before. Amen. This God knew, this king knew he needed God in his life, didn't he? It scared him when he figured out that they hadn't been serving God the way God wanted him to. It should scare you if you're not serving God the way he wants you to. Amen. Because he's a jealous God. Amen. Even in the Ten Commandments, it says, thou shalt not have any other gods before me. Amen. And what did the children of Israel do? Huh? They made other gods. And they felt the wrath of God for it too, didn't they? Same thing going to happen to you if you don't listen to what God wants you to hear from him. Amen. Now, that's in the old Bible. Now, if you'll turn over to the new Bible, we're going to hear from God. From Christ. And in the New Testament, in John, the 4th chapter, we're going to start at 28th verse, but we're going to give you a little reference into this. Christ was with his disciples, and he was over out of Jerusalem. Where was he? He was in Samaria. What did the Jews think about the Samaritans at that time? That they were dogs. Didn't they, Johnny? Didn't they count them as dogs? Because they weren't pure. They had interbred with other people other than Jewish people. So the true Jews in Jerusalem wouldn't have anything to do with them. They told them they were as dogs. They had forgotten about it, even though they were part of Israel. Yeah. But if you don't know God, you're separated from him. And you might as well be considered a dog, because when you die, you're not going where God is. Amen. Amen. You're not. Anyway, Christ and his disciples was over in over there at the well in Samaria. And there was a woman there. She was a harlot. And she hadn't lived well. And she'd had several husbands. And God and Christ tells her of the things in her life. Now we're going to pick up and read in the 28th verse. No, let's start with the 25th. The woman said unto him, I know that the Messiah cometh, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things. And Jesus said unto her, I that speak unto thee am he. Now he is the Messiah, and he was the Messiah. And upon this, his disciples came and marveled that he talked with the woman. Yet no man said, why seekest thou, or why talkest thou with her? The woman left her water pots and went her way into the city, and said unto the men, come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ? Then they went out of the city and came unto him. They went out of the city and came unto him. In the meanwhile, his disciples prayed him, saying, Master, eat. But he said unto them, I have meat to eat that ye know not of. Therefore this said the disciples one to another, hath any man brought him aught to eat? And Jesus said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. Amen. That's what we need to be doing. We need to be doing about the Father's business. This is who Christ was thinking about here. He's already told this woman everything that she'd ever done. And this woman went into the city and said, listen, this man is at the well out there. He told me everything that ever I've done. Is this not the Christ? Amen. So the people come out to see him, to see this man who could talk and know about people. But his disciples still didn't understand, did they? They didn't understand who he was and what he was doing. Jesus said unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work. say not ye there are yet 4 months, and then cometh the harvest? Behold, I say unto you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, for they are white already to be harvested. And he that reapeth receiveth wages, and gathereth the fruit to eternal life, that both he soweth and he hath reaped may rejoice together. And here is the saying true: one soweth, another reapeth. I send you to reap that whereon you bestowed no labor. Other men laboreth, and ye shall enter into their labors. And then if you'll skip down to the 39th verse. And many of the Samaritans of the city believed on him for the sayings of the woman, which testified, he told me all that I ever did. So when the Samaritans were coming to him, they besought him that he would tarry with them. And he abode there 2 days. And many more believed because of his own words. Amen. Many believed on Christ because they heard him. Amen. And said unto the woman, now we believe not because of the saying, for we have heard him ourselves and know that this indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world. Amen. They believed not because she told them, but because they heard him. Amen. Have you heard him? Has he knocked at your heart's door? Has he tried to get your attention and you've turned him a deaf ear? God wants you to change. He does. He wants to live in your heart and your life. And he can. But it requires you to do something. It's to let him in. Amen. Are you willing to open up your heart and let him in? This woman at the well knew that he was different. She knew he was something. She knew that he was Christ. Not many people knew that back then. But God granted her that knowledge. Yeah. So that she could tell other people. And she went into the city immediately and said, hey, listen, come out here. There's a man out here at the well. He knows everything. Come and listen to him. Is this not the Christ? So they had to come and hear. What do you think they heard? They heard Christ. Not only did they hear, they believed. Aha. Uh-huh. Yes. We need to hear God's word. But the most important thing to do is to obey God's word and to do what God wants you to do. Can you hear him? If you can hear him, he's knocking at your heart. And you need to open up and let him in. Amen. Then you can be like the woman at the well. You can know who this Christ is. Amen. God opened up her sight so she could see and know who he was. And she went in to tell the city, and they came out to Christ, and he opened up their knowledge of who he was. They didn't believe because of a woman. They believed because they heard Christ. Christ is knocking at your heart's door, and you can hear him today if you open up your mind and let him in. Amen. He'll make the difference. He'll wake you up. There's an awakening in God. Amen. You need to listen to him. You need to drink some of this water from God's well. Amen. From this water from God's well is a living water. Christ told him, said, if you drink of this water, you won't thirst anymore. Amen. It'll satisfy you forever if you let God in your life. Amen. Don't you want that? Don't you want God in your life? Let me tell you this. You need him. You need him. Remember the king? He got upset when he figured out they weren't doing what God wanted them to do. And this woman that God woke up by telling her everything she'd ever done, she says, you're the Christ. God gave her that vision to let him know. Can you hear God knocking at your heart's door? Can you feel him? Can you feel his presence close? Amen. Did you feel God's spirit moving in the song and when the girls and the boys up here were obeying what God wanted them to do? Couldn't you feel God's love in the house? Can you feel God's love dealing with you right now? Amen. I can. I know he's alive. I know that he loves me and he loves you. I can be like the woman at the well. God, give me knowledge to know who he was. Amen. And he'll give you that same knowledge. And he'll let you drink of that same water from his well. That satisfies your thirst of him forever. Amen. That you will want to serve him and to have his blessings in your life. Don't you want God's blessings in your life? I do. And he wants to bless you. Do you know that? God wants to bless us. All we have to do is let him. Amen. I'm through. If they'll guess the song. I want you to know one thing though. Our world's in bad shape. They need to awaken to what God wants them to hear in their lives. Now God has talked to us throughout the ages. He's still talking today. He has preachers. He has men of God and women of God. He has the Word. You can go on Sunday mornings and flip on television and hear a message, can't you? You can turn on your radio and hear a message. My goodness, you didn't even go to YouTube and hear me. Can you believe that? It scares me to death sometimes. But God wants you to hear His Word. We have no excuse for not knowing God. None. And he's not going to accept any excuses at the end of time either. And whether we're here when he comes back or if he calls us home, we can't make any excuse. You can't say, well, God, I didn't have opportunity. You have. He once winked at ignorance. He doesn't anymore. You have a lot of ways to find out about this God in your life. You have the Bible. You have all the things that we just mentioned. And he wants you to hear him. He wants you to wake up. There needs to be an awakening. Amen. Wake up, people, and hear God. Can you wake up? Let's stand. Can you hear God? Is he knocking at your heart? Don't you want him in your heart and your life this day? He wants to be there. He wants you to have him.
Hurting and broken within, overwhelmed by the weight of your sin, Jesus is calling.
Can you hear? Can you hear?
Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, come to
come on.
The altar. The Father's arms are open wide.
Forgiveness. Yes.
It's here.
Right here with God in your
precious
life. Forgiveness.
Blood
it's easy.
Of Jesus
come and confess your
Christ.
Sins to Christ.
Leave behind your regrets and mistakes. Sing hallelujah, Christ. the altar. Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Are you hurting and broken within? The weight of your sin, Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
From sin of this world, so that you can find Him and have Him in your heart and your life forever.
Oh,
if you'll just come to Him and turn your life over to Him. Amen.
Father's He'll make the arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with precious blood.
Amen. Well, thank you, Lord. You know what we need before we need it, God. We thank you for that. Well, we thank you, Lord, for coming and be with your children. We thank you, Lord, that you can help us, the Heavenly Father, believe in you, and we can come together and praise you, and you come and be with us in our midst. We thank you for that, the Heavenly Father, this day. Amen. Deb, do you want to say anything?
I feel wonderful.
Amen. God bless you. I have felt wonderful this day in my life with God. I feel wonderful when God confirms things. Amen. Has God confirmed anything in your life today? Amen. Has He confirmed to you that He still lives? Woo! And He'll come and be with His children who love Him. He will and does, doesn't He? Woo! Amen. Amen. What? Yeah. Yeah. Gladys' his daughter. Yes. But we're all in God's family if we know Him. Amen. Isn't that wonderful? But isn't it wonderful when we move stuff out of the way and let God in? See? See? Come on. When you get off of your comfort spot, after you get away from that and let God in, isn't it wonderful? Amen. Woo! I am so glad that God loves us. I can just shout. I might do it anyway. Well, amen. God loves us, amen. And He wants us to love Him back. Amen. The children of Israel today in our lessons that they were given of the things that He had made the Egyptians give them back in the desert where they could build them a tabernacle. And they came back and gave it to God. But He blessed them again, amen. You can't outgive God. He loves you. And if you'll turn your life over to Him, you're in for some blessings, amen. You're in for some blessings if you'll listen to God. But you're in for some trouble if you don't, amen. I'm going to try to hush. I don't know if I will or not. But God dealing with people this day. He is. He's talking. And he's dwelling in this house. Amen. He's with his believing children. Amen. He is. He's here. Trust me. And he wants you to listen and obey. Are we through? I suppose we are. Amen. Ain't God good? God's good. We love him this day, and we love you. And we want to continue to thank God for blessing us. Amen. We're so blessed that we just don't understand how much. Amen. But let me tell you, we are. I love him this day. Remember, come back tonight. He might have another blessing for you. Amen. Amen. You know, I always get it wrong when I say the time, but it's 5 o'clock tonight, right? 5 o'clock. Can y'all stand another blessing? I can. And God's got one for us if we'll believe upon him. Amen. He will. He'll bless us, Brother Weld. He will, Brother Fred. He loves us this day. And I want you all and everybody to love him back.